UK citizens have possibly got an out-of-date view on what we're doing here. I honestly think it's not hard work at all.
We've got a well-established, which we've taken many years to build up, Eastern European relationship, of course, where pickers have come back year on year. So we do have a feeling of loyalty towards them, but at the same time, it's great to have an opportunity to work with the local populations. Come and try picking again.
I'm Claire Pullen. I've been on the farm for a couple of weeks now. My background is I've been working the last 9 years in the oil and gas industry. I love my job. I'm on furlough leave at the moment. And I knew the British fruit farmers were struggling with COVID, getting employees, so I thought I wanted to help the British farmers.
My name's Michael Pell, and I've been in the hospitality industry for quite a while, and I feel that it was the right time for me to find out a little bit more about the farming industry, which is quite a passion of mine. And I came up with Hall Hunter. I found out that it was a very well run family business, and it was local to me.
I'm Pippi, Pippi Williams. I am a student. Well, I was meant to be doing my A-levels this year. I came here through my local church community and I wanted to earn some money. I am considering uni next year.
Initially I was very impressed, certainly with the welcome that they came. They sat us all down, we had training. We really felt it was done professionally, very friendly.
It was really good actually. On the first day, the whole day was spent introducing us to the farm, about how they operate, what kind of values they respect and what they expect from us. And also it was really important about the health and safety involved. They've definitely told us that we're having less people per tunnel. We want to ensure that you're keeping 2 metres. We've had separate break times and we keep exposure to as minimum as possible.
We want people to realise their full potential. We take the time to train them properly. We don't ask them to do a full day on the first day they arrive. And so we're kind of investing for a season and then the next season, so we hope they come back again.
Our experience so far with the English recruits has been very positive. Currently, after 2 weeks, we have around 100 people, and we're hoping that remains constant over the course of the season.
It can be hard work. It's the nature of the business. We get at least the national minimum wage here. They're very generous in the sense of what they pay per hour. And then the more you pick, the more they reward you.
It's a great company to work for. It's very professional. They look after you, not just during this time. It's something that UK citizens should come and do and get involved.
I definitely would put it on my CV. I think, you know, to show those core skills of persevering, teamwork, being diligent and sticking to the job.
I look at the picking pool as our future management. There's a clear pathway from becoming a picker to a supervisor to going down the growing route or going down the people management route, and you can do both. It doesn't matter where you come from, it's available to all.
When you go to the field, they're getting on well together, it's a happy group. I think they're developing friendships for life in the field, and also hopefully it's a positive experience for them and us.
It's so nice here because we've got a community sense of feel. We really get along, and the harder you work, the more money you get.
I would be very happy to stay working on the farm if they have me until the end of my furlough leave, which at the moment is to the end of June, but I'm hoping it's going to be longer.
We went into it being a little bit sceptical, but actually it's been very successful so far. We're into about 2 weeks of it, and we can't see why it won't continue through the season.